At RGBA, look at this, guys. Big news, something big. Jake Paul announced that he has a fight. Are you fighting Jake Paul?
I'm fighting, I'm retired.
Big G, who do you want Mikey to fight? Who do you want to see Mikey fight? Okay, let's do it. I love it. Man, Mikey, the gym is a beehive. Look how many fighters are here. This is wild.
Good work.
Look, and even Chema's
young
here.
Look at all the young blood right here.
You have Ray Morataya. You have everybody.
Yeah.
Who are you going to spar, Mikey? Anybody can get it. Are you going to go easy on the guys, Mikey?
What's that?
Are you going to go easy on them?
We always work. We're here to work.
I'm glad to see you back doing what you do best. I think you have a few fights left.
Yeah, I'm not fighting.
No, that's how it starts, though.
I'm losing weight. I'm getting too fat. I gotta lose some weight.
Did you see any of the influencer card?
Who?
The influencers?
No.
Did you watch it, Felipe?
I didn't watch it. I was
a different event. So Ryan Garcia said he'll fight three of the influencers all in the same night. 4-4-4.
He's an influencer, too.
He's a boxer.
He's more social media. Unless he decides to do a real boxer.
Well, no, he said that he's going to take it. Until now, he went 50%. Now he's going to go in 100%.
That's what it takes to be a true fighter, true champion.
And he said
can't
that he...
half-assedness.
He paid too much attention to social media, and now he's focused.
Good.
Did you get him up this one?
No, I have had those off.
By the way, Bomac was live on ESPN. Did you see that little interview?
I saw that.
What did he tell him? What he said?
No, I don't know he was there. I saw the fight.
They interviewed him and they said, what happened with the gun? He said, it was in my suitcase for months. I forgot about it. That's what I said.
That could be.
Yeah?
So did they catch him on the way there?
Or no, on the way back. On the way back here. On the way there, I think he flew private. Nobody checks private. Mikey, after your yacht, your next thing is a private jet. No one's going to check anything. I'm glad he's out.
I gotta make a lot more money in order for me to afford something like that.
Okay, so fight Floyd. December 9th. Hey, you heard about this? Regis said that Haney had 17 fights in Mexico. And Regis said that one of the fights he lost, Haney lost, and they paid to have it changed to win. And he said that's the weakest shit he ever heard.
Is that fact?
I don't know if it's true.
It could have been a mistake that he, somehow lost on DQ or something.
He switched it?
But not necessarily that he lost the fight.
I don't know.
Especially not when he's fighting in fucking TJ. You're not losing those fights, bro.
What would be my record if I fought in TJ?
You're not losing those fights.
I'm not losing.
You could turn pro and go 10-0 over there.
Let's do it. 10-0, 10 knockouts.
For real.
Imagine it. Mikey, if you did all your fights in TJ, you'd be, what? If you did all your fights in TJ, 40-0 and 40 murder cases.
I'd be
89-0 with murder. Why is he wearing a jacket? It's hot today.
He's learning.
Rafa Jr. in the house?
Yeah, he's learning.
No? Pita!
He's trying.
Mikey against Mayweather, what do you think? Can I ask you a question? Why are you wearing a jacket?
Like a sweat, lose weight.
Why don't you just work out then?
I don't like working out. It's not healthy for him. It's not healthy for you. I'm going to go into the gym. He's going to pass out. He works out. Yeah. Once he throws and he's done and you start jabbing.
89-0, like Chavez Sr.
When you're fighting in Mexico, you fight a lot of guys that are not at your level. You just rack up the wins. You gain experience. That's what Henry did. He fought higher men camp in Mexico. That was building a record, building, developing as a fighter. He's not fighting in Mexico right now he's fighting here against champion.
And I thought he lost to Loma. You and Loma, major fight, if that could happen. How about you and... Mikey, you and Loma, can we make that happen? It's a big fight.
Never happened when it should have happened. I'm retired.
But maybe you come out of retirement. Nobody's retired in this sport ever. Marquez retired, came back. A lot of fighters retired and came back. Mayweather retired and came back.
Out of the way. Ahí está.
Mayweather didn't retire. He took a year off to avoid having the rematch clause with De La Hoya. Came back a year and a day later, exact, fighting Marquez.
You think that's what it was?
Oh, that's exactly what it was. When you look at the facts, that's exactly what it was.
John Jones stepped away from the sport for 3 years, came back and looked great.
He stepped away for other reasons.
Shout out to John Jones, that's the homie.
Yeah, he's cool. I met him once.
He's a good dude, very friendly. Yeah, he's a huge boxing fan.
I met him once. He probably didn't know that I met him or whatever, but I met him once.
He knows. Cool dude. He is a very cool dude. Cool, you have a lot in common with him.
I have a lot in common with him.
He loves guns. He loves animals. He had like, what's that big cat that cost like $40,000? He had like two of them.
Savannah cat.
Savannah cat. And he has three Rottweilers. He likes to have fun. What's wrong with that?
Yeah.
And he's a very cool dude, Mikey. He's very cool. Last time I saw him, he had all these security. He said, go away. Don't get near me. He saw me. He's like, come in now. Like, he's normal.
Yeah.
You don't like superstars that go Hollywood. Do you like sparring, Mikey?
Yeah.
Why?
Because it's much better than hitting the back for 10 rounds. Hitting a speed guy. That's just boring. Out of the car, get a sweat in.
And it's a highlight for the young fighters, too.
It motivates the young kids.
To bring their A-game.
Three or four rounds of Mikey, you know?
Yeah. Cool. It gives their confidence booster. So, wait, in your career, besides Loma and besides Gamboa, anybody else you wanted to fight that didn't happen? Like, you and Crawford could have happened, right? Not really.
The one that was close and never happened was Manny Pacquiao. We were close to getting that two or three times.
The last one cost him $21 million or whatever.
Yeah.
But that should have happened. What would have happened in that fight?
It would have been two or three. There was two or three times where we were very close. It didn't happen.
I wish it happened. That would have been massive. He's a great fighter. You're a great fighter.
That would have been a good fight.
It could still happen, Mikey.
The fans would have really enjoyed that fight.
I think it could still happen.
I don't know.
Why not?
I'm not looking to fight anymore.
Yeah,
I'm here to have some fun and break a sweat, do some work.
What if they give you an offer you can't refuse?
I don't think that exists at this point.
You never know. Someone's watching this video and say, you know what?
Nothing could be that exciting.
Mayweather,
Pacquiao. I would do it, not even for the money. I would do it because, oh, fuck, it's Manny or Mayweather. Fuck it, let me share the ring with them. No, let me feel what it's like. You know, I do it for that reason. But
if it's not for that, no.
They're not for that. Not for that.
Are you not cutting this till you win a championship? You're not gonna cut it till you win a championship?
Yeah, until I have a boy.
A boy? How many girls you got?
I got one girl.
What if you have seven more girls? Could happen. Do you eat meat products or are you a vegan? Do you eat a lot of meat products?
Yeah.
Okay. No, I made a joke. But listen, love your kid no matter if it's a boy or a girl.
Yeah, no, for sure. Healthy baby.
Right, Mikey? Just love your kids.
That's the best love, the best form of love. Nothing compared to that.
What do you think of Benavidez Boo Boo? It's official, it's happening, they faced off. You know both?
That's a good fight. That's a good fight. Boo Boo's very tricky. Very good doctor.
Yep.
Very tricky. Difficult to hit. He can move around well. That's gonna be a good fight for David.
David's on my pound for pound list. He himself says no, but I know a talented.
He's up there.
He loves boxing. He's into it. But that's good. You had a good weekend though. Anything exciting?
I was in Tennessee.
No way. What's out there?
Nashville. Rob Luna. Financial advisor, he had an event.
He went to support
private event that he had a small group of people, and he had a strong Ryan, former CEO, former experience.
Yeah.
Talked to the group. Really good event.
That's cool. It's not easy to be a Navy SEAL.
You bring home a lot of knowledge from those events.
Who in the gym here you think would do good in a Navy SEAL?
Navy SEAL?
Yeah.
Hardest
working
motherfucker.
Which is
that
who? Antonio?
Look at the size of that motherfucker. That can work hard.
Bam.
Bam.
Brandon Reels.
Reels. At his time when he was
a hard worker.
Now he pulls around too much.
He wants to fight Blueface and he wants to fight Jake Paul. He texts me once in a while, Ellie, give me that fight. What's the movie Field of Dreams? If you build it, they will come. And now, like, this gym opened up. There were four horses and no fighters. And now, like, there's about 30, 40 people, no parking.
Three rings. And they're all busy.
Full of sparring. Where's Frank the Cook, by the way?
Working.
Yeah, I'm gonna turn it again. All right.